Thanks, John, for that introduction. I constantly remind John that he's getting older, so he needs to make sure he keeps track of his notes, but he's doing well. So I'll try to go as quickly as I can and also speak as slowly as I can, because I tend to speak a little bit fast. Being a marketing person, you just go through things as quickly as you can, and sometimes you forget exactly where you're going. But as John was saying today, my topic today is on marketing and promoting your Herefords, which basically summarises into marketing communications, which is my role with Herefords Australia. And as John said, I've been here since January this year. I'm based in Brisbane and I commute to Armidale once a month. And I've been getting out and meeting different people and being out at Steve's farm and really getting a handle on what's happening in the Hereford industry. And I'm really liking what I see so far. There's a lot of potential. And it's about, for me, I see that marketing is a massive area. It's an area that's got a lot of debate about it. So be aware that some of the ideas and concepts and theories that I'll present to you today, you may not agree with them. They're based on a lot of my own research and experience and that of the colleagues and friends that I've worked with, so and that I rely on myself. And a lot of them have been tested and tried, and that's one of the things that I'm not going to present something to someone that I haven't tried myself. So I'll move forward. So as I said, these theories today that it's on marketing and comms that I've tested and tried myself, and that for you as commercial operators will be able to use and you can implement so in your business. And that's important that you see that this is possible. So as I said, they're based on my own experience that I've been tried and tested, and this takes time. Be aware that this when you're researching, when you're learning and getting a handle on marketing and comms practices and actions, they do take time. So just be patient with yourself, be patient with the people that you may employ or get to do these this work. Some of them may or may not work for you. For example, when Danica was talking about Facebook and Twitter, there's also another one she left out, which is called Instagram now, which is just photos. It's like a Facebook, but it's just for photos. So these theories, these practices, they're always evolving. There's always something new coming on board. And even myself that have been using social media for nearly the best part of 10 years, sometimes even I look at it and I just go, what on earth is this? I don't know how anyone can understand it. But it's important to not be afraid to get out there and to use it. And to do the research. Don't be afraid to do that. Don't be afraid to ask questions from people that you that may know more than you. So now something that I'm going to tell you, which may stun some of you, but you're all marketers. You're all in the business of promoting your own business. And you're probably sitting there thinking, you know, this little young gun has lost the plot. Well, I haven't. Just bear with me and don't get too shocked. You may, but you may not. And the question for us today is, what can you do as marketers to create the most profit for your business while also having a maximum positive impact? And that's what marketing is about. It's about creating a positive impact for your business, having a positive impact on the lives of other businesses and other people. So I've separated this my speech today into two areas, which is marketing and then communications. And I want to emphasise something that marketing is not. So marketing is not just advertising in a newspaper. Those are a few ads that I scanned and kept in there today, but when you see that, I'm not sure how some of you feel, but it's not just advertising in a newspaper. This is where marketing as a concept will broaden your horizons. It'll open up a whole new range of opportunities for you. So, and one of the hardest things to do in your business is to as opposed to working in your business, is to work in your business and to demonstrate one company that has really done a lot of their own marketing very, very well, that I think, and it's a bit of a juxtaposition to it because it's on the opposite scale of your off the Hereford industry, is Coca-Cola. And I'm going to show you a video that is one of their ads. And the reason why I'm showing this to you is there's three reasons which I've just put up there. It's iconic, it's reliable, and it's got sex appeal to it. And they're three aspects that advertisers, that marketers are using today with all the modern technology to grab attention. And surprisingly, you'd be amazed at how believable some of these marketing these techniques are. And Coke has done it through one of their ads. And I'll just bring it up for you. And it's called The Gardener. It's been on YouTube, it's been on TV, predominantly mostly in the UK, but it's still coming out here in Australia. Mostly, so coming out in the UK last year. So have a watch. Don't get too shocked, but yeah, we'll go. And I'll ask you a few questions afterwards, so make sure you take note. Information that I've put together. The first one is, I don't know if what some of you said, what were some of the key points that separated this ad as opposed to maybe some of the other ads that you see? So what are some of the key points of this advert that has separated them from other ads in today's marketing, advertising area? Does anybody have any? Well, okay. Sorry? That's true, yeah, that is actually a very good point. That is actually a very good point. So what were some of the key marketing points of this advert? Okay, the first one that I've put together, and I'll answer these for you, is notice how they sexualise the man. Sexualisation of the men today is not very common. It's still emerging. There's a whole heap of marketing done on women because it's just been, that's just been the genre, that marketing of women has been a lot easier. Marketing of men are shy. We don't like to be, you know, some guys, particularly regional, rural men, don't like to be photographed. It's embarrassing. It's considered a question with your sexuality. So that's one of the first parts. The next part is that this presents the perfect image of what the man should be. All men should be muscly, they should drink Coca-Cola because this is what it's going to do to them. When in fact it's full of sugar, it's not a healthy diet. But let's be honest, people don't differentiate between Coke and Diet Coke. General populations, they've got the name Coke out there, they haven't accentuated the word diet. Notice that part. The music, it's confrontational. It's saying, make love to me. Like that's, it's full on. It's a bit more than most music in an advertising commercial would be. The women, they're inspirational, they're rich, upper class, they're seen as what women want to be, or what women should be. And the cinematography of the ad. Notice how the Coke can was slow, it was in slow motion, and the guy lifted up his shirt, it was all in slow motion to accentuate, the feeling that Coke gives you, that makes you feel good. It oozes that sexual tension and makes the viewer want to take notice. So, the next one, the next question that I had was, why do you think Coke did the ad in this way?
Coke.
Besides the obvious. Okay, it's persuasive. Okay, it's young people in my generation, I don't know, I'm talking mostly also city people, believe this. It really is believable. The credibility, they want to make their image of Coke appeal to the younger generation, which is that 18 to 30, 35 year old age group. They want to make themselves look good. It's all about your image. And there again, it's image appeal. They portray to the younger generation that life is all about image, and that by drinking Coke, Diet Coke, this is what you'll be able to have. And obviously to increase production, increase their profit. Okay? And these are all points that I'm saying to help you when you're in your marketing strategies and your marketing plans to take into account. This is what Coke is doing, and this is on the unhealthy side of the food marketing area. How much more can the beef, can Herefords do for their in terms of marketing strategies that are around? And you've seen also the lamb ads and how appealing they are. The lamb ads with Sam Kekovich are one of the most appealing meat ads around in the world. They're done brilliantly. I didn't use them deliberately because, as an example, also because they're on the same scale as you. So I'm trying to help you to see outside your spectrum. So the next. So, what is marketing? Just remember, this is just a summary. It's not a full-blown explanation. Otherwise, we'd be here all day. And to give you a bit of an idea, I'm just going to go through the who, what, why, where, and when, and how of marketing to try to match these some of these points to how you would put together a marketing strategy. And my general rule of thumb has always been quite simple. Marketing is the action of researching your market in order to identify your primary and secondary customers. So you've got there's your primary customers, which for some of you may be are the breeders, and then your secondary customers are the general public, those that you're trying to promote the beef product to. It uses a variety of tools for a specific purpose to a specific person. So, for example, in the Australian Banana Growers Council, or the Australian Bananas, an arm of the company that I used to work for, they aimed their marketing at the 18 to 39 year old age group, because that's who they're saying single 18 to 39 year old people are not eating bananas. So that's what, in terms of when you say a specific person, is the you're being very specific about that. And I was going to go through another video. So this other quick video, I've got another one as well, which is a video that's been done by a company that has been researching the effects of marketing in two particular areas. And this is why I'm saying, when you need to research. So this is not as confrontational. Been aimed at describing the target of women in marketing. So just have a watch. This is just to give you a better idea of what I'm explaining.
Oh,
finish it there, but that's just basically given the stats, because I'm pressing for time, that's just basically given the stats of what American girls are consuming in terms of advertising, media, promotions, and how much people are viewing today. So that's just a quick summary. Okay, so the next part is the who. And the first point I want to make here is that you should never be fooled into adopting a one-size-fits-all solution. This is where you need to do your research. You need to find out, you know, be specific about putting together a marketing strategy. Finding out the who of your business is appealing to, make sure you analyse the different factors of a person's identity. For example, what's their age bracket, their gender, their marriage status, their employment, their location, and do they have children? These are all facts that, for example, when Danica was talking before, Facebook, for example, is using. And to be really specific, on my phone, depending on the apps that I've downloaded, Facebook will target me with different marketing when I bring up my Facebook on the internet. So if I've got, for example, a healthy food app, they'll start targeting me with healthy food options. It's all linked in. If I've got, when I was engaged, they started targeting me with marriage information, to buy marriage material, for weddings and all that sort of stuff. Then I got married, then they started targeting me with children information, buying paraphernalia for my child. Then I had a child, then they start bombarding me with more information for a child. So this is how targeted marketing is becoming these days. And don't be afraid to ask these questions and to put these questions into your strategy, because they're all valid, and you need to understand who your customer is. The next part is, and this is one of the most vital parts of your campaign, is the what in your marketing strategy. The reason I say this is you have to question, what is your marketing, is your campaign for, your marketing strategy. And I'm merging the two words campaign and strategy together, and I'll explain why in a little while. What is the message that you want to achieve? And what do you expect will be the outcome? And this is a very important part. And the reason I say this is that there's no point creating a strategy if you can't deal with the outcome. For example, if it means that you're going to get a flood of calls, hypothetically, are you able to deal with that? Are you able to deal with the supply issues? Are you able to deal with the financial side of it? There's a whole range of aspects that you need to be aware of, and this is where it comes down to research. The next part is why. Why does your market, your buyer, need your product? I'm sure many people don't ask this question when they put together a strategy. And why does the seller want to sell? Why do you, the seller, want to sell this product? These are all, they're basic questions, but they're vital to your strategy. And that's where also, if you can't answer these questions, you won't be able to convince your buyer. You won't be able to come up with the end strategy. Now this is an interesting part, because this is the where. Okay, there's different ways, there's different places you can include of where you're going to market your strategy. TV, these are all options that you're able to think about. Local TV is a very good option as well, because local TV is specified to different areas, as opposed to if I want to do a TV commercial, for example, in Brisbane, it just gets shown to all of Brisbane. Doesn't get just shown to a couple of suburbs. So think about advertising alongside specific shows. For example, Australian Bananas advertised during the Glee show in 2012, because the target audience was the 18 to 39 year old age group, which was the viewership of that show. Radio. What radio stations are you? Can you advertise at? Advertise with? And think about the audience of the radio station, and think about the time of when people would be listening. And there's a whole range of more questions that you can think about when you're looking at these options as well. Newspapers, one of the most common, obviously. What newspapers? Regional, commercial, local. There's a whole range of them there. And then you need to think about your page numbers, your sizes, your colours. There's no point just coming up with a full page ad or a quarter page ad and then just saying to the agent or the advertiser, just chuck it anywhere. Because you'd be surprised how many times people look and scan newspapers and don't even see it. You want your ad to be front and centre, you know, as close to the front of the area that you want, to the front of the newspaper. Or, for example, when Herefords Australia, when we advertise, like, we will ask, you know, if there's editorial in that area, you know, and to put our advertisement with that editorial as opposed to just, you know, back of the paper or etc. So you've got to be strategic about it. And also to think about, you know, the size and the colours that you're using, because these are all effects that will catch the attention of your buyer. Online, the social networking sites. And as Danica was saying, was very useful information about the social networking, because these are options that particularly the younger generation are using today. And specific websites, for example, Herefords Australia has advertising on our website, and these sort of options are available. So the next part is when. Are you going to do it today, tomorrow, next week? Be strategic about it again. Look at what other events are happening at the same time in your relevant region. If you're doing a strategy, you know, is it going to tie in with another event or another occasion where you can include your strategy in terms of when you're advertising or if you're going there to set up for an event or to be present at an event? And for example, when I was one of the campaigns that I worked on the beginning of last year, in 2012, was called the Eat Australian on Australian Day campaign, which was put together by a number of agricultural organisations. And it needs to be held, for example, the day before Australia Day. It couldn't be held on Australia Day, because otherwise it wouldn't have got any attention, because everybody was on a public holiday. It attracted national attention. And it got the word out there. We used Twitter, we used Facebook, and these were still mediums that we're still developing of how we can benefit. We got national attention. It was on ABC, it was on Channel 7. The only place we didn't get was Sunrise, because that's quite difficult to get on, but nevertheless, the word got put out there, and it will be developed further from there. The next part is the how. One of the most important parts here is attention to detail. And I've used a couple of examples just to give you an idea of what I mean. Now, I've blocked out the names for obvious reasons. Business card from Telstra from one person that I got. And another business card, someone also from Telstra. Can anyone tell me what the problem is? Oh, I've blocked them out, obviously.
One's easy.
No. Okay, that's an old business card of mine. And another business card from someone in the same company. I've blocked them out. They're the same. Notice those two, Telstra, are different. It's actually quite poor and actually really surprising. So uniformity. No, actually, I specifically picked that up from someone in Telstra because I knew that they had separate business cards, which is really quite funny. Even though one's a business person and the other one's just a consumer, that uniformity is really important because it helps people to see that there's a common theme, that there's the same understanding when you're getting advice. If I go to one Telstra shop or another, or one Telstra person, I would hope that I would get the same advice from both, but evidence points otherwise. So, how does all this information apply to Hereford breeders? And how do we put all these questions into practice? So there's a few different options that you've got. And these are some of the methods of marketing that I'll run through.
Do I have a bit of time still?
Okay, so the first part is when you're doing a website, I'm sure and I'm hoping that some of you have thought about this option, have at least thought about this option. Okay? It's very real. And a lot of breeders are getting out there and doing it, and it's great that you are. First one is find a designer. Don't think that you have to do it on yourself by yourself in Microsoft Word, because it doesn't. You're wasting your time. I wouldn't, for example, try and fix my own car. I take my car to a mechanic because I'm not a mechanic. I'm a marketing communications professional. Same concept. I'm not going to get a website, try and do my own website. I'll take it to a website designer and developer, because you don't just need a designer, you need a developer who's going to do all the coding in the background. I hope I haven't confused you there. Get your colours right. It's really important that when you develop a website, you don't just, you're just not blasé about it. And research. Research the information, research the images, research the titles, just everything that you need about the copy that you need on there. And as I said before, just make sure you get captivating images, and I'll touch on that in a minute as well. And I'm going to show you a couple of examples of some pretty bad websites and some pretty good websites. Colours are horrendous, I'll be honest. The lack of information, it's not up to date. Next one. Too much information, red, is great, but it's slightly offensive as well. And these are things that you understand through research. I'm sure most of you look at that website and you wouldn't know where to look. There's too much information on there. There's no, I'm looking at for prices, parts price, and I'm seeing parts price list, notebook price list, system price, what price list am I meant to look at? Okay, and these are some of the websites that have been won the awards in recent months. This one was given the best overall visual design. Great feel about it. Royal Ag Society of WA. Headings at the top, very clear, easy to find. Information, disclaimer information down the bottom. How to become a member. Their major events on the front. Best overall not-for-profit. All the campaigns that they're doing, the Eat Smart, Shop Smart, Cook Smart, images are clear, the colour is slightly easier to on your eyes, and a bit of information about themselves. Best overall mobile site. So this is another option that needs to be taken into consideration, is websites that are capable to be read on iPads, iPhones, smartphones, Android phones. Big issue at the moment with development of websites, because it's more than likely that people are looking at this stuff on their phone in the car. And this was the best. Not when you're driving, but obviously when you're out on the road. This was the best commercial one, and this is probably one that most of you would want to make sure you take a look at. And I found this, I like this site. So they've got all their information, what we do, products, blog, and then they, you know, what we do. Underneath they've got let's get technical, you know, projects, our work, contact, and you know, find us. And the information is there. It's easy to, you know, it's just straight in front of your face, and that's what you want when you're using a website. So the next part is advertising, and I'm talking about print, online websites. Be creative. Don't be afraid to be creative. Another concept that you may have seen on a lot of in some of the rural press papers is the little barcodes that are on there, which you can scan with your iPhone and links directly to your website. So these are tools that you can use on your print advertising that will generate attention to your website. Again, if it's necessary, invest in a designer to create the artwork for you. be accurate in what you're describing, in what you're advertising, and be prepared to cope with the responses. And opportunities of advertorial, Carla might want to block her ears here, don't hesitate to ask. These are options that are available to you, whatever paper you're looking at. The next part is images. A good photo says 1,000 words, and I see it time and time again. The use of bad photos and I'll show you one in a minute. Make the investment of quality digital camera and take the time to learn how to use it. It's not rocket science. It is, you will learn how to use it eventually. If my mum can do it, anybody can do it. Have a look at other adverts and see what is acceptable in terms of a good photo. And I'm going to show you an example in the real estate industry. The use of bad photos and the lack of photos is horrendous. I did a search on properties in my area, and this property came up with just one photo. Now, if I was looking to rent, buy, whatever that house, how would I on earth know what is inside that house?
Treehouse.
Well, that's the only photo on there. There is no way I'm even going, I'm going to want to have to go there. I mean, the look of it, I don't even want to, I wouldn't even be bothered. So that's just an example of situations that are around, and it's disengaging for your audience. Okay, the next part. I do have to skip. But if you, I'll make this available on our website. There's some statistics about social media that are around at the moment, actually dating back to just from 2011, by the end of 2011, and how important social media is. So you've already seen all the information from Danica. And very quickly, first communications mistake. Don't pitch too much, too many, too often. Contacting more media doesn't necessarily help you to get more coverage. The real secret lies in your ability to create 4 to 5 highly targeted pitches and go for only a handful of media at a time. I realise that some of you may or may not need to engage in these sort of in media strategies in terms of preparing media releases. Some of you may. It's something that you have to explore, and there again, you need to research the validity of it. How do you approach the media? You'll never get a response from media if you send blanketed and untargeted press releases and fail to follow them up with another email or telephone call. First-hand experience, I've done it, doesn't work. Journalists receive hundreds of emails every day. It just doesn't work like that, particularly over other major national headlines. The media, and there again, the media are after stories, not just adverts. So you need to make sure that it's that you're on target, that the message is there. And the next part is failure to research your key points. Research is essential, focus on the story, not the business. For example, if you've got someone in your business, that, you know, is an interesting part of your business, that, you know, you can use to feature, I've forgotten what my example was here, but take time and opportunity to use them, and don't be afraid to help them to engage in this opportunity. And there again, keep media releases and news on target. Make sure that they follow the same formula of the publication or medium, e.g. for example TV. Like for example, Today Tonight focuses on scams, weight loss products, celebrity gossip, whereas you know, a home magazine might focus on home improvements, real estate information. The fact remains is that the more media you want, the more targeted you will need to become, and the more you will devour the publications or shows that you will feature in. The last part is, go and get started. Don't waste any time. Don't be afraid to do it. You're free to ask me questions where it's possible and where I'm available on email. and happy to answer questions where as possible. Also, some of the technicalities on social media, feel free to come and ask me. I'm a prolific Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn user myself, so feel free to come and ask. And I've tested every option that is possible in those areas. And the last part is, make sure you keep up to date with news. Herefords Australia website, we are regularly updating news and we're separating from not from news and Herefords Australia information. Check out Twitter, it's a great site for great form of meet or marketing to find out the latest news and information. You can specify all the Herefords news you want just by following different Herefords, Hereford breeders, Hereford organisations. There's some of them on our Twitter site that we've been contacting recently. Cattle News, Beef Central is a great one to use to highly target the beef producers. There's also other rural press news sites as well that are definitely worth your while. And there you go, the rural press publications. Make sure you get on their mailing list for your local region, which you can do through Twitter and through email on their websites. So these are just some of the organisations that I credited some of my information from. And if anybody's got any questions, you're free to ask me during dinner. I'll be happy to answer them. And my contact details are on the website and they're available for you if you need. Thank you.